trained repetition, but repetition for a very specific end of life purpose.
Isn't it in secular meditation, don't you repeat something?
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, almost.
So it's almost like, I guess if you're really familiar with the novena, I mean, or the litany, then you're free to, you know, get.
Exactly.
Hear what God, the Holy Spirit's trying to tell you.
And see, that's one of the things, you know, we talk about how we are incarnational, meaning, you know, Christ became flesh for us. So that we could see who he was, so we could talk to him, and, you know, and people could reach out and touch him. This was done purposefully because we are very tactile people. And the see, touch, feel. I mean, there's a reason why we have incense and bells and all sorts of stuff, because at the beginning, God's very specific about all these things. You must use this specific kind because it is mine and it's holy. Don't you use it for anything else but this. It's mine and it's holy. But using it like the repetition, because things that we almost as humans do naturally, it's like to repeating something over and over again, it's when it's comforting. And, you know, like I said, you don't have to think too terribly much about it. We're already kind of jumbled up in our heads anyway. Mm-hmm. But, and especially since I probably got it before the 60s, but in Hindu, repeating the word that the divine spoke at the creation, you know, Om, you know, the resonance or repetition of that, and, you know, it's almost become like a joke in ours. But I mean, it's like, oh yes, I'm gonna pray now. Yeah, mm-hmm. I mean, and you know, the sound of resonance, you know, things like that. But bells, but. To help us put ourselves into that more meditative state. Mm-hmm. I mean, especially when it comes to prayers before the Blessed Sacrament. I mean, because you don't want to have to concentrate too terribly hard and stuff sometimes, but there's specific things you can say over and over again that even the saints have encouraged us to do, just for the fact that it helps us to focus on the specific thing, especially the name of our Lord. Just over and over again, or the very short, you know, Jesus, Mary, Joseph, you know, that over and over again, so that we can focus, mm-hmm. and through that, our minds and our prayer actually begin to articulate themselves, even though not necessarily consciously on our lips, but we begin to articulate a prayer without realizing it. Mm-hmm. Like St. Paul talks about the groanings of the Spirit, or the Holy Spirit trying to speak through us, not necessarily our tongues, but you know, that's for another talk about another day. Yeah. But just to be able to focus and to hone in on that specific aspect of what we're trying to articulate and can't, because our spirit prays for and through us, especially with the Holy Spirit, for things we do not know how to ask for, or do not know what to ask for, how to ask them, but it comes from the depths of our heart, it comes from the very seat and center of our soul is just, I have no idea what I'm asking for, but I'm in great pain or a great need, and I'm just going to, Lord Jesus, have mercy, Lord Jesus, have mercy. And then that comes from that. Because as it says, God knows what we're going to ask before we ask it. And it doesn't, you know, negate the needs necessary in prayer, but it helps us to understand that when we get that prayer out, we also realize what we need. And that helps us articulate. And God always likes to, he's the great teacher, yeah. The good shepherd, teaching and guiding us. How do I pray? What do I pray for? If you don't know, ask, as St. Paul talks about. And these prayers can be a lead into what we need to ask for, so that our soul articulates that in our minds.
Does that include ejaculations? Like, mm-hmm. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, you know, the myriad.
Or sacrament, most holy, mm-hmm. or sacrament.
Because we can use just about anything as a litany.
Mm-hmm. One of my favorites is St. Thomas, or Thomas the Doubter, mm-hmm. my Lord and my God. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I say that after every Mass, the elevation of the precious body. And it just, I get such a warm feeling when I say that.
It's always good, especially Peter, my Lord and my God, Thomas, I believe, help my unbelief, too, also, the various ones. I said that to somebody who's like, well, I believe, help my unbelief, and they're just like, Father, like, no, it's a prayer, it's biblical. I'm not having a crisis, I promise not. If I was, I wouldn't really tell you about it, but, okay. We're fine. Okay, we're good because I actually had nothing else to talk about. I mean, wow, yeah. So.
Thank you. Thank you.
Father Adam, can I get a copy of what you have? Because I brought nothing.
Sure.